the prophets of Allah and his messengers. For truly Allah has sent them just as he has sent me. Allahu Akbar. So in the same way as we say As-salatu was-salamu alayka ya Sayyidi ya Rasulallah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we say also As-salatu was-salamu alaykum ya Anbiya Allah. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صلوا علي فإن صلاتكم علي زكاة لكم. قال وسلوا الله لي الوسيلة. قال فإما حدثنا وإما سألناه. So they want to ask. So here Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم is saying bless me, for truly your prayer, your blessing on me is a purification for you. Zakat. So the literal meaning is purification. And the literal meaning of purification is physical. And includes everything. So it's physical as well as moral and spiritual. Now, so salat and salam on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a purification for us. And then he says, and ask Allah for me the wasila, the means. And they were wondering what he means by that, the means, the wasila. He said, either he will tell us or we ask him. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم الوسيلة أعلى درجة في الجنة لا ينالها إلا رجل وأرجو أن أكون أنا ذلك الرجل. The means is the highest level in paradise. No man except one will obtain it, and I hope to be that one. اللهم بلغ الوسيلة أمن. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال صلوا علي فإن صلاتكم علي زكاة لكم وسلوا الله لي الوسيلة. Same hadith. And he said إنها أعلى درجة في الجنة. It is the highest level in paradise. ولا ينالها إلا رجل واحد وأرجو أن أكون أنا هو.
Sheikh, this wasila is higher than Firdaus or Firdaus is higher?
No, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is higher than all the paradises. Otherwise, the awliya, why would they ask for to be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? They want to be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because he has, it is like all the paradises put together and more. Because he is closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than the paradises. Since there is in paradise, being in paradise, and then there is the vision of Allah in paradise in addition to that, you see. So therefore there is something more than paradise, and if anything that has to be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And then عن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم سلوا الله لي الوسيلة لا يسألها لي مسلم أو مؤمن إلا كنت له شهيدا أو شفيعا أو شفيعا أو شهيدا. So ask Allah for me the wasila, the means and the nearness. No Muslim or believer asks it for me except I shall be witness for them or intercessor for them. Or vice versa, intercessor for them or witness for them. And so we should also remember that the Prophet ﷺ said, bless me and then ask the wasila for me. Not vice versa. Not to delay the blessing until after asking the wasila. But rather, first we ask. And then, first we bless him. So, Allahu Akbar, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah Muhammadan Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hayya 'ala as-salah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah. And then we say, Allahumma salli 'ala sayyidina Muhammadin 'ala ali sayyidina. Allahumma balighhu al-wasila. Like that. And all of the dua. That is the well-known dua. Allahumma rabba hadhihi da'wati at-tamma wa salati al-qa'imah and so on. وبه إليه عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه يقول قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الوسيلة درجة في الجنة عند الله ليس فوقها درجة. There you are. So وسيلة and the means of nearness to Allah is a level in paradise or a level with Allah in the divine presence. There is no level above it. ليس فوقها درجة. So منصوص على هذا النص. فأسأل الله أن يؤتيني الوسيلة على خلقه. Now, so ask Allah to give me the means of access over His creation, meaning to be the one that is nearest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they said that that is the maqam shafa'a. And the place of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in some hadiths, and it has been mentioned as explanation of asa an yab'athaka rabbuka maqaman mahmuda, as the throne, as the arsh itself. And Imam al-Tabari strongly defends this riwaya from Mujahid in explanation of that ayah sharifa. وعن عبد الله بن عمرو رضي الله عنهما أنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من صلى علي أو سأل لي الوسيلة حقت عليه شفاعتي يوم القيامة. Whoever blesses me or it really should be وسأل لي الوسيلة and asks the means for me, this is what you have. أو
من صلى علي أو سأل.
Yes, so it should be وسأل لي الوسيلة. والله تعالى أعلم. I also have أو. And as the means to, of nearness for me, then truly my intercession will be incumbent, will be rightful for them on the day of resurrection. عن عون بن عبد الله رضي الله عنهما أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن في الجنة مجلسا لم يعطه أحد قبلي وأنا أرجو أن أعطاه فسأل الله لي الوسيلة. Truly there is in paradise a sitting place مجلسا. هذه إشارة إلى العرش. There is a seat that none shall be given before me. And I hope to be the one to whom it shall be given. So ask Allah for me the means of nearness. You see, because Prophet ﷺ from his humbleness saying, could be other than me. It could be another prophet, another messenger, another one that Allah chooses. That's from his humbleness. But as they explain, if Allah says asa, it means haqqa. And it will be for you, O my beloved. عسى أن يبعثك ربك مقام محمود. That مقام محمود, that مجلس, that وسيلة, that special مقام, which in other hadiths also is described as the arsh and the kursi, is for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما يقول اللهم تقبل شفاعة محمد الكبرى. هذا دعاؤه عند بعد الأذان. نعم. وارفع درجته العليا وأعطه سؤله في الآخرة والأولى كما آتيت إبراهيم وموسى عليهما السلام. ما شاء الله. So this is a special dua of Ibn Abbas. فهذا بدعة في العبادة مقبولة حسنة مرضية وسنة حسنة ولكن ليست نبوية ولا تشريعية إنما هي سنة من الصحابة الكرام ومن ترجمان القرآن وحبر الأمة ابن عباس رضي الله عنهما. Oh Allah, accept the intercession of Muhammad, the great intercession of Muhammad, and raise up his rank his high rank and give him whatever he requests in the next world and the first life as well, just as you gave Ibrahim and Musa upon the mountains. وعن أبي شريح قال حدثني رويفع الأنصاري رضي الله عنه أنه سمع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من قال اللهم صل على محمد وأنزله المقعد المقرب منك يوم القيامة وجبت له الشفاعة. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said whoever says oh Allah bless Muhammad and cause him to alight upon the seat of nearness to you on the day of resurrection, my intercession will be compulsory for him. Mashallah. See the seat of nearness again?
Yes.
طيب. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما جلس قوم مجلسا لم يذكروا الله ولم يصلوا على نبيهم صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا كان مجلسهم عليهم تيرة يوم القيامة. إن شاء عفى عنهم وإن شاء أخذهم. ماذا كيف فسر تيرة؟ تفسير تيرة
شاغرة؟
لم يفسرهم؟
لم يفسر.
طيب. So no play, no group of people sit in any gathering without mentioning Allah and blessing His Prophet, their Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, except such a gathering of theirs on the day of resurrection will be counted against them. If Allah wishes, He will forgive them, and if not, if He wishes, He will take them to task for it. Subhanallah. This is why we always begin by saying Alhamdulillah wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad. After Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, يعني من شأن الأشياء كل شأن يعني كل ذو شأن يعني things that are that we consider important to us, we begin with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, not the trifling matters. كما قال عن أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال ما من قوم يقعدون ثم يقومون ولا يصلون على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلا كان عليهم يوم القيامة حسرة وإن دخلوا الجنة لما يرون من الثواب. طيب. أبو سعيد said there is no group that sit and then get up after their gathering and they did not bless their prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم except that on the day of resurrection they will be regretful of that, they will be deeply remorseful of that, and even if they enter paradise they will not see in it وَإِن دَخَلُوا الْجَنَّةِ عَلَيْهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ حَسْرًا وَإِن دَخَلُوا الْجَنَّةِ لِمَا يَرَوْنَ مِنَ الثَّوَابِ عَفْوًا لِمَا يَرَوْنَ مِنَ الثَّوَابِ. So they will be regretful even when they enter paradise because of the huge reward that they see for what? For blessing him. And they didn't do it. And this is confirmed in other hadiths. Among them the hadith that says the only thing that the people of paradise will regret is that they did not make more zikr in dunya. Because of the same reason. عن كعب بن عجرة رضي الله عنه أنه قال ألا أهدي لك هدية. So هذا حكمه مرفوع. So because Abu Sa'id would not say this from his own opinion or ijtihad, therefore the status is the status of a prophetic report because it is telling us about ghaib, reward of paradise. So someone said, Ka'ab said, shall I not give you a gift? Inna Rasulullah, so his gift is a report about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kharaja alayna, he came out to see us. قال فقلنا يا رسول الله قد علمنا كيف نسلم عليك فكيف نصلي عليك. So Allah said صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. So they were asking يا رسول الله we know how to give you سلام سلام عليك. We know. So سلام عليك or عليكم or السلام عليك السلام عليكم. And some people they say سلام الله عليكم. But السلام is the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So Now they're asking about salat. So he said, قال صلى الله عليه وسلم قولوا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Oh Allah, bless Muhammad and the family of Muhammad just as you blessed Ibrahim. Truly, you are most glorious and majestic. عن كعب بن عجرة رضي الله عنه, same one, قال لما نزلت هذه الآية إن الله وملائكته الآية. So as we said, the context, this expands on the context of the previous hadith and it is identical to it. And then he asked, إن الله وملائكته صلوا على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلم تسليما. قلنا يا رسول الله قد علمنا السلام عليك فكيف الصلاة؟ قال صلى الله عليه وسلم قولوا اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت وصليت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. قال وكان ابن أبي ليلى يقول وعلينا معهم. So the faqih of Medina ibn Abi Layla say also add وعلينا معهم. يعني إن صلاة إبراهيمية say إنك صلي على كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وعلينا معهم إنك حميد مجيد. ما شاء الله. So take that and try to put it into practice. And this shows also that there is this inclusion of us. It's always, you know, with the salawat from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his Aal, his companions, and all prophets, and Anbiya, and all Awliya, and the whole Ummah, and us included. Now, mashallah. Al-Ka'b ibn Ujra again, قال قلت يا رسول الله قد عرفنا السلام عليك فكيف الصلاة عليك؟ قال صلى الله عليه وسلم تقولون اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وآل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. قال ونحن نقول وعلينا معهم. ما شاء الله. And we say at the end and on us also, just bless us also. So this we is عبد الرحمن بن أبي ليلى, the one who narrates from the Sahih. محمد بن عبد الله بن زيد عن عقبة بن عمرو رضي الله عنه قال أتى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم رجل حتى جلس بين يديه. A man came and sat in front of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فقال يا رسول الله أما السلام عليك فقد عرفناه وأما الصلاة فأخبرنا بها كيف نصلي عليك؟ قال فصمت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى وددنا أن الرجل الذي سأله لم يسأل. So a man came, sat in front of Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, asked him the same question. So probably that man is كعب بن عجرة والله أعلم, or someone else, because or it is related to كعب and عقبة بن عمر as well. And he asked that question. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم stayed silent a long time until they said, "We wish he had not asked him, because." Subhanallah, they liked for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to speak more than to watch him to be silent, as if, you know, there was some distance between them at the time of his silence, you see. So they liked to be interacting with him, subhanallah. Though his silence was for waiting for revelation and for the reply to the question. And then he said, فَمَا قَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِذَا صَلَّيْتُمْ عَلَيَّ فَقُولُوا اللَّهُمَّ صَلِّ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ النَّبِيِّ الْأُمِّيِّ وَعَلَى آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ. So this is giving us more forms of salawat Ibrahimiyya. See here, al-Nabi al-Ummi. And there are many, and it's good to mention them from time to time, not just one, single one in all our lifetime, but to put into practice the whole sunnah like that. And say sometimes, وَعَلَىٰ أَزْوَاجِهِ وَعَلَىٰ ذُرِّيَّتِهِ. And here, al-Nabi al-Ummi, وَعَلَىٰ آلِ مُحَمَّدٍ كَمَا صَلَّيْتَ عَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَعَلَىٰ آلِ إِبْرَاهِيمُ وَبَارِكْ عَلَىٰ مُحَمَّدٍ النبي الأمي وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبه إليه إلى يزيد بن عبد الله أنهم كانوا يستحبون أن يقولوا اللهم صل على محمد النبي الأمي عليه السلام. They love to say, oh Allah bless Muhammad the unlettered prophet upon him peace.
شيخ,
زيد
بن عبد الله is a تابعي or
Yazid, you have Zayd?
I have Zayd here, sorry.
You have Zayd?
Yeah. because this Allahumma salli ala Muhammad al-Nabi, most of the awliya, they have this as a word in their daily
and they took it from this.
Yes.
And this is a most probably a tabi'i.
Yeah.
Or tabi' al-tabi'i.
Yeah.
Because when they say كانوا يستحبون, it means either the Sahaba or the Sahaba and the Tabi'een. And his shuyukh, the previous generation, the older ones that he took from. كانوا يستحبون أن يقولوا. So if he's a Tabi'i, it means the Mashyakha of the Sahaba. وعن عبد الله رضي الله عنه يعني ابن مسعود أنه قال إذا صليتم على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأحسنوا الصلاة عليه فإنكم لا تدرون لعل ذلك يعرض عليه. So whenever you bless the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, make your salat on him beautiful. أحسنوا, make it excellent. أليس هذا دليل على الاجتهاد في العبادة وفي ألفاظ العبادة التي هي الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ يعني ولو كان شيء جديد يعني محدث مبتدع ولكن بالمعنى الحسن, هو قال أحسنوا الصلاة عليه فإنكم لا تدرون لعل ذلك يعرض عليه. وهذا ابن عباس وابن مسعود, he says both of them they are known to have invented new salawat on Prophet, and he is saying make it beautiful, therefore inventing a new salat that is accepted in the best sense of doing your best and with full sincerity for the sake of pleasing Allah and pleasing the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is the tahsin of salat on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And this is the right ijtihad that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم اجتهدوا in ibadah. And therefore, like saying, اللهم ربنا ولك الحمد حمدا طيبا مباركا فيه ملء السماء وملء الأرض وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شئت بعد, like the Sahabi did inside salat. So this distinction that it is bid'ah, lughawiyya, but not in ibadah, etc. These are all later distinctions that the Salaf al-Salih did not think like that at all. But rather, there are forms of ibadah in which you are encouraged, not just permitted, to make up whatever your sincerity compels you to say at the time of your need, of zikr, of shukr, of salat, and of mahabba to Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like this, أحسنوا الصلاه عليه. So you don't know whether it will be shown to him. قالوا فعلمنا. So they said to Ibn Mas'ud, teach us then. He said, قال قولوا اللهم اجعل صلاتك ورحمتك وبركاتك على سيد المرسلين وإمام المتقين وخاتم النبيين محمد عبدك ورسولك إمام الخير وقائد الخير ورسول الرحمة. And سيدنا علي رضي الله عنه also has a great one, صلاة الفاتح, also narrated from him originally. اللهم داحي المدحوبات, that famous hadith, long one, where he says محمد الفاتح لما أغلق بما كان أغلق والخاتم لما كان قد سبق, and so on and so forth. So you have seen now three, Ibn Abbas, Ibn Mas'ud, and Sayyidina Ali, only three of the greatest ones making new, technically, bid'ah salat, hasana, on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And salawat is ibadah. So this distinction that it cannot be in ibadah is wrong. Cannot be. It is mentioned, it took place even in the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in front of him inside salat, and he accepted it and he made it sunnah. طيب. So this is a teaching for us. And he said, اللهم ابعثه مقاما محمودا يغبطه به الأولون والآخرون. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. طيب, نقف هنا إن شاء الله, نختم الكتاب في المجلس الذي الثالث إن شاء الله إن أحيانا الله. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Any question? سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون. سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. And I will read a line of poetry from the grandfather of the Sheikh with whom I read part of this book. He said, وَاعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ حُبَّ آلِ الْمُصْطَفَى لَوْ مَرَّ فَوْقَ جَمْرِ نَارٍ لَنْ طَفَى. Know that the love of the family of the elect Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that love, if it were to pass on top of hot coals and flaming fire, it would go out, that fire, from the coolness of that love of the family of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayfun wa'lam bi'anna hubba ali al-Mustafa, and know that the love of the family of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sayfun bihi yudrabu haddan wa qafa, is like a sword, yani against shaitan, that with it you strike shaitan front and back, yani the front of the sword and the back of the sword, yani any which way, or that shaitan, yani coming to you or running away from you, you strike, still striking shaitan with that love of family of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّ حُبَّ آلِ الْمُصْطَفَى عِبَادَةٌ وَتِلْكَ حَسْبِي وَكَفَى. And know that loving the family of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is worship, and that is enough for me and enough for you also. Alhamdulillah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.